This video is about coordinate systems in general, and then we're going to specifically talk about the Cartesian coordinate system, because that's what we're going to use, at least in this course, and in most lower level physics courses, you'll be using the Cartesian coordinate system. But we're going to start off talking in general, then we'll go into the Cartesian. So a coordinate system is just a set of unit vectors to define the dimensions of space. We live in a three-dimensional world, so most of our coordinate systems that we deal with are three-dimensional, so there should be three unit vectors. It is possible to go into higher dimensions if you're doing maybe stuff in computer science or in theoretical physics or in, you know, theoretical math. We are going to stay in the real world, which is three dimensions. So I just want to give you some examples of three-dimensional coordinate systems. Like I said, the one we're going to use the most is called the Cartesian. It's also known as the rectangular coordinate system. There is also a cylindrical coordinate system and a spherical coordinate system that are also commonly used in physics courses. So you may actually see these ones, especially in physics 2 when you're talking about electric fields or magnetism. These coordinate systems will make sense in that area. We are going to stick to the Cartesian coordinate system. So the unit vectors, and you may already be familiar with these a little bit, but we are going to define these unit vectors, x hat, y hat, and z hat. These are the unit vectors that define the three-dimensional space of the Cartesian coordinate system. So in the picture that you see here, you might notice that this is a three-dimensional picture. I'm trying to show this in a two-dimensional plane, so I hope that you can kind of see the three-dimensionality of it. In this picture right here, I have the x unit vector, sorry, that y hat unit vector is pointing towards the right, the z hat unit vector is pointing up, and the x hat unit vector is actually supposed to be coming like out of the board at us. So this is actually three dimensions. And you'll notice here that all three of these unit vectors are perpendicular to each other. So x hat is perpendicular to y hat, y hat is perpendicular to z hat, and z hat is perpendicular to x hat. So each of these unit vectors is perpendicular to both of the other unit vectors. That's very important. And these unit vectors define the three dimensions of space. So in any problem, you can define these three unit vectors, and you can express any vector in this space in terms of these unit vectors. And that's what we're going to do from now on, is express our vectors in terms of these unit vectors. So let's talk a little bit more about three-dimensional space. We already talked about it a little bit when we just started talking about vectors. The plane of the board, or the plane of your computer screen, describes a two-dimensional space. That's a two-dimensional plane. So like in this two-dimensional plane, if you were looking at your computer screen right now, you could define two different directions that are perpendicular to each other. One is horizontal, and in one sense of that horizontal direction is to the right. The other sense is to the left. In the vertical direction, one sense is going up, the other sense is going down. So the direction is vertical, but when I say sense, it's describing like the direction of that direction. So it's a little bit confusing in the English language. We don't have unique words to describe this. So I try to use the word sense to describe one, the way of pointing in that one direction. So like up and down are senses of the vertical direction. Left and right are senses of the horizontal direction. And now in 3D, imagine another plane is coming out of the board or going into the board compared to this plane of the board. This is the third dimension. And so this dimension also has different senses. And so these two senses that I would describe it as is out of the board and into the board. Those define a line. And in one direction, it's going out of the board, and the other direction is called into the board. So if you're okay with left, right, up, and down, you need to also be comfortable with the third dimension that has two senses, out of the board and into the board. It is really hard to draw these things, so I'm going to do my best. A lot of times we're going to limit ourselves to just a two-dimensional plane, but we will describe this third dimension in terms of into the board or out of the board. You do need to be able to describe those things. So let's talk a little bit more about this Cartesian coordinate system. There's a couple other rules that you need to know. The Cartesian coordinate system is defined by what we call a right-hand rule. This is a rule you'll see over and over again, and it's describing the directions of these three dimensions. It's describing the unit vectors that describe these three dimensions. So in order to understand how to do a right-hand rule, first you have to make a particular shape with your right hand. So hold up your right hand and make an L with your pointer finger and your thumb. So hold up an L, and now kind of bend your middle finger so that your middle finger is pointing straight outwards away from your palm. So this is the shape of your hand that you want to make this shape and then lock it in. Notice that there is a perpendicular angle between your pointer finger and your thumb. There is a perpendicular angle between your pointer finger and your middle finger. There is also a perpendicular angle, you can kind of see it, perpendicular angle between your middle finger and your thumb. So the way that your hand is pointing, these are your three unit vectors, X hat, Y hat, and Z hat. So make these assignments to the various parts of your hand. Your thumb is X hat, your pointer finger is Y hat, and your middle finger is Z hat. Memorize that, memorize this shape, and now any way that you can rotate your hand, the Cartesian coordinate system is allowed to rotate. So you can assign like different dimensions to each of these different unit vectors. Like X hat doesn't always have to point along the horizontal direction. Y hat doesn't always have to point in the vertical direction. If you can rotate your hand, as long as you maintain this shape and you maintain the 90 degree angles between all of your pointer, middle, and thumbs, then now you have any of the combinations that are acceptable for the Cartesian coordinate system. So in a way to kind of finish out here, let's try testing out our right-hand rule capabilities and let's see if you can identify, let's do some examples and make sure that you understand how to do this right-hand rule. So like I said, you can rotate your hand any way you want as long as you maintain that shape. We're gonna define different Cartesian coordinate systems. So we'll do that in just a second. Like I kind of was already saying that each of these directions has a positive and a negative sense to it. And so how we actually define those senses, we get to choose two of them and then the third one is defined by our hand. So just to kind of reiterate, the senses and the symbols that we use to describe these senses. So the first dimension I'll just call the horizontal dimension. The senses of it are left or right. And so arrows that point left or right is how we would symbolize those dimensions. In the vertical dimension, we would say up or down. So we can draw an arrow that's pointing up or pointing down. That describes the two-dimensional plane. And now that third dimension is either pointing out of the board or into the board. So the symbols that we use, they look like either an X or a dot. And then I like to put circles around them just to kind of make sure that you're aware that this isn't just some random X or some random dot that's on the paper. The X symbol, this is the one that symbolizes into the board. And the little dot, that symbolizes out of the board. The reason that these symbols exist and why they look like they do has to do with an arrow. So imagine that you shoot an arrow towards the board. It's an arrow that is going into the board. As the arrow travels away from you, you would see the crosshairs on the tail of the arrow. So that's why the symbol for into the board looks like an X or a cross. It's because it's symbolizing the crosshairs of an arrow that is getting shot into the board. And likewise, now imagine an arrow that is shot out of the board and it's traveling towards your face. All you would see is the tip of the arrow. So this dot symbolizes the tip of the arrow that has been shot out of the board. That's why those things look like that. So you might be asking, well, which way is positive and negative? She's saying senses left, right, up, down, into the board, out of the board. And the answer is you get to choose two of them. And then the third one is defined by your right hand. So basically you get to assign X hat is going to be horizontal, Y hat is going to be vertical. And you get to decide if you want right to be positive or left to be positive. You get to decide whether you want up to be positive or down to be positive. And then that third dimension, whatever sense is positive in that dimension now is defined by the right-hand rule. So let's do a couple exercises here. Let's try this system number one. I've told you that X hat is going up, y hat is going to the left. So let's use our right hand to define that third dimension, the unit vector for that third dimension. So your thumb is x hat. Point your thumb on your right hand, point it going up. Make that L shape, and now your pointer finger, point it to the left. And now make that shape so that your middle finger is pointing like out of the palm of your hand. If you've done it the way that my right hand works, my thumb is going up, my pointer finger is going to the left, my middle finger is pointing at me. I see the tip of my middle finger. That's like the tip of an arrow that has been shot out of the board. So in this case, Z hat is coming out of the board. I have three other systems that you can give this some practice with. I will give you the answers to these things, and I want you to try to check, really use these examples. I'll do another one with you. Let's make that shape with our right hand. Make the L shape with your pointer and thumb, and now have your middle finger coming like outward from your palm. This time, Y hat is pointing out of the board. So that means your pointer finger should be pointing straight at you. So you should be looking at the tip of your pointer finger. Z hat is pointing up. So this one requires a little bit of bending of your arm. In order for my pointer finger to point straight at me and my middle finger to point up, my thumb is pointing to the left. So X hat is your thumb. All right, let's try another one. X hat, so my thumb, make that shape with your hand. My thumb is pointing into the board. So twist it so that the tip of your thumb is now pointing like towards your computer screen. That's the board. So point your thumb into the board. Now it says that the Z hat unit vector should be pointing downwards. And so to do that, now I have my middle finger is pointing down. My pointer finger, now that I've locked in this shape, my thumb is going into the board, my middle finger is going downwards, my pointer finger is going to the right. So Y hat in that case was going to the right. And now for the last one, my pointer finger should be going down, my middle finger should be coming out at me, my thumb is pointing to the left. So pointer finger going down, middle finger is coming straight out at me, my thumb is pointing to the left. So check your right hand, make sure that you're twisting it and locking in that shape and trying all this stuff out. You should have gotten those answers for that. And now the next thing we're gonna do, I just wanna introduce this, this is what the next video is gonna be all about, is now that we know what our coordinate system is, we're gonna use these unit vectors to now express every vector in terms of these unit vectors. And so we're going to create some scalar components. We're going to use those to create vector components, and we are going to build vectors in the Cartesian coordinate system.